tectonics. What is plate tectonics? Plate tectonics is the first theory to provide a comprehensive view of the processes that produce Earth's major surface features, such as continents and ocean basin. Continental drift to plate tectonics. In 1960s, most geologists held the view that the ocean basins and continents had fixed geographic positions and were at great antiquity. Less than a decade, late researchers came to realize that Earth's continents are not static. Instead, they gradually migrate across the globe. Because of these movements, blocks of the continental material collide, deforming the intervening crust, thereby creating Earth's Great Mountain Chain. Furthermore, land masses occasionally split apart as the continental blocks separate and creates a new ocean basin. The resolution began early in the 20th century as a relative straightforward proposal called the continental drift hypothesis. We also strictly trace the development of the continental drift hypothesis, examine why it was first rejected, and consider the evidence that finally lead to the acceptance of its direct descendant, the theory of plate tectonics. Continental drift. The idea that continents, particularly South America and Africa, fit together like a piece of a jigsaw puzzle. Until 1950, when Alfred Wegener, a German meteorologist and geophysicist, wrote The Origin of a Continent and Ocean. Wegener's hypothesis, continental drift, which dared to challenge the long-held assumption that the continents and ocean basins had the fixed geographic position. Wegener suggests that a single supercontinent he called Pangaea. Evidence in the continental drift theory. The continental jigsaw puzzle. Like a few others before him, Wegener suspected that the continents might once have been joined when he noticed the similarity of the coastline on opposite sides of the Atlantic Ocean. These opponents correctly argue that shorelines are continually modified by wave erosion and dispositional processes. In early 1960s, Sir Edward Bullard and two Ushants constructed a map that pieced together the edge of the continental shelves of South America and Africa. Fossils match across the sea. Wegener's hypothesis came from a remarkable similarities at the continental margins. It was when he learned that identical fossils organisms had been discovered in rock from both South America and Africa. A classic example is Mesosaurus, an aquatic fish catching a reptile whose fossil remains are limited to black shales of the Permian period in South America and Southeastern Africa. Another example is Glossop theris seedworm, as evidence for the Pangaea. This plant identified by its thong-shaped leaves and seeds that were too large to be carried by wind, was known to be widely dispersed among Africa, Australia, India, and South America, and later on found in Antarctica. Rock type and geologic features. Wegener found evidence of 22 billion years old igneous rock in Brazil that closely related to aged rock in Africa. Similar evidence can be found in mountain belts that terminate at one coastline. This includes the Appalachians threads northeastward through the eastern United States and disappears off the coast of Newfoundland. Another example is the mountains that is comparable age and structure of British Isles and Scandinavia when these land masses are resembled. Ancient climates. Rigidor suspected that paleomatic data might also support the idea of mobile continents. Glacial striation and grooves like this are produced as glaciers drag rocks debris across the underlying bedrock. Near the end of Paleozoic era, ice sheet covered extensive area of the southern hemisphere and India. Rigidor's proposal did not attract much until 1924, when his book is translated to English, French, Spanish, and Russian. In 1930, Artie Chamberlain, a respected American geologist, criticized Rigidor's hypothesis. He said that Rigidor's hypothesis is an ugly fact. Rigidor's hypothesis of continental drift is correct, but contains an incorrect data. In 1968, these developments, among others, lead to the unfolding of a far more encompassing theory than a continental drift, known as plate tectonics. The uppermost mantle of the overlying crust behaves as a strong, rigid layer known as lithosphere, which broke into segments commonly referred to as plate. In turn, overlies a weak region of a mantle known as a asthenosphere. The Earth's major plate is called lithospheric plates or tectonic plates, where lithosphere is composed of about 24 segments with irregular size and shape. Plate boundaries. One of the main tenets of the plate tectonics theory is that plates move as semi-coherent units relative to all other plates. Because plates are in constant motion relative to others, most major interaction among them occur along their boundaries. Kinds of plate boundaries. Divergent boundaries, where two plates move apart, resulting in upwelling of hot material from the mantle to create new seafloor. Convergent boundaries, where two plates move together, resulting in an oceanic lithosphere descending beneath. Transform fault boundaries, where two plates grind apart each other without the production or destruction of lithosphere. Divergent boundaries. Divergent boundaries are also called spreading center. Oceanic ridge and seafloor spreading. Most divergent plate boundaries are associated with oceanic ridge, elevated area of the seafloor that are characterized by high heat flow and volcanism. Rift valley. Axis of some ridge segments is a deep down fault structure. Seafloor spreading. A mechanism that operates along the oceanic ridge system to create a new seafloor. Continental drifting. Divergent boundaries can also develop within a continent. Continental rift. Tectonic forces continue to pull the crust apart. These crustal fragments sink, generating and elongated. Convergent boundaries are also called subduction zone because they are the site where the lithosphere is descending. Deep ocean trenches are the surface manifestation produced as oceanic lithosphere descends into the mantle. Oceanic continental convergence. The leading edge of a plate cape when continental crust converges with a slab of oceanic lithosphere. The buoyant continental black remains floating while the denser oceanic slab sink into the mantle. Oceanic convergence. where two slabs converge, one descends beneath the other, initiating volcanic activity by the same mechanism that operates at all subduction areas. Continental-continental convergence. The third type of convergent boundary results when one landmass moves toward the margin of another because of subduction of the intervening seafloor. Transform fault boundaries. Along a transform fault boundary, blades slide horizontally past one another without the production or destruction of lithosphere. Fracture zones, where transform faults are typically part of prominent linear breaks in seafloor.